Okay, so here they built the place. This is again invading. But with reason, supposedly. To protect or against a repeat of the past. Because there they will come. And then there was no warning. This is the end of things. Here I stood and struck them down as they came. My family and my clan, with their false faces, they dropped all pretense and drew their weapons against me. I fought them to the last, killing the shape-changers that had taken their forms. I cursed them for destroying the dream. But they were not the real evil. The real evil could not save my people before this deception. The real evil hid from life in the face of this tragedy. The real evil deserves the blame. This is the end of things. Answer where blame has fallen. Okay, so option one is the blame falls upon the invaders who attack mercilessly and honor a people who cannot defend themselves. It falls upon the craftsmen that built this evil place and on you for telling them to. The blame is shared by all in your eyes. The real evil. And he's making the distinction between the real evil. He's saying is not the invaders. So what I take from this, I fought them to the last. They were not the real evil. The real evil could not save my people before this deception. The real evil hid from life. The craftsmen encouraged you and egged you on, so you're without blame. Your people demanded too much from you, so you're without blame. The invaders were unstoppable, so you think they're you are without blame. All others contributed to your downfall. You know the saying three ways. We probably have to come back here a third time. I probably missed something somewhere else. The blame begins with the invaders, but the attack was supposed good reason. Huh, yeah. If he agrees with what that one is saying. It could be on your people, but they were in the shelter of your confidence. The craftsmen only did their jobs as directed. In your eyes, you are the one to blame for all that has happened. Your people are without blame because the invaders were unstoppable. The invaders are not to blame because they were fighting for survival. The craftsmen just did their jobs, and you could not foresee the attack, so you were free also. None are to blame in your eyes. I don't think that's right. He's saying the real evil could not save my people, blah, blah, blah. I will not choose now. Your people must share blame for their inability to fight, and the crafters must share blame for their willingness to encourage you. You must share blame because you began it all. The invaders are not to blame, for they only did what is in their natures to do so. Inability to fight, willingness to encourage you. I'm not sure. And finally, I think, yeah, the invaders are to blame for the slaughter of your people and should be blamed for the helplessness they felt. They also contributed to your hiring of the craftsmen, so they are indirectly to blame for the tower as it stands. They are the true evil in your eyes. The invaders contributed to the hiring of the craftsmen? Right. Didn't this place was around before Durlag came? Well, the underground part was. And he built the tower on top. Is that what it is? Something like that? We have killed many over time. There's not our wills. All to protect against the repeat of the past. Well, the challenges ensure it will repeat. We crafted as we were told. But supposedly not from Durlag then. Not told by Durlag. And then he says here... The craftsmen. They could not save the people. And the craftsmen hid. I mean, maybe six? Blame is shared. I don't see anything that specifically says, yeah, the craftsmen are to blame. This just absolves him of blame. This says the blame falls upon the invaders and the craftsmen. Oh, everybody. Okay. The blame begins with the invaders. The craftsmen only did their jobs. You were the one to blame. Could be. Could be he blames himself. People without blame. Craftsmen just did their jobs. No one is to blame. You people must blame for their inability to fight. Craftsmen must share blame. So everyone but the invaders. Maybe six? Does he blame himself? This is, seems to be the closest one. Let me just look back at this. Because I'm not sure. We're here before. As were the tentacles. I haven't seen any tentacles. I guess six. The invaders are to blame for the slaughter of your people and should be blamed for the helplessness they felt. They also contributed to your hiring of the craftsmen, so they're indirectly to blame for the tower as it stands. They are the true evil in your eyes. I'm not sure this is right. You have failed to understand. You will answer again. Oh, God.
My. All right.
Oof. Magic resistance against its own thing.
I don't want to talk.
Sure.
Maybe...
Sure.
The rest of us should stand away as we answer this.
Go pet. All right.
So it's not six. Maybe he is here saying himself. The real evil could not save my people before this deception, which he could not. The real evil hid from life in the face of this tragedy. He retreated down below, so maybe it is himself. He deserves the blame. The blame begins with the invaders, but the attack was supposed good reason. It could be on your people, but they were in the shelter of your confidence. The craftsmen only did their jobs as directed. In your eyes, you are the one to blame for all that has happened. You have understood. You may yet survive what I could not. Oh, okay. And we're back here. With this, ghosty.
Squeaky wheel gets the kick!
You have found the room that gives direction, but are not done yet. They way. The way is not yet clear. Understand the paths that lead away, and you will return. Okay, so we probably have to hit something else. See, because here we press that, I believe. And then... where was it? Over here. We hit that. I think it was this. Huh. Is it something over here that I missed? I wonder if it even has anything to do with these tunnels. What about this? Looks like a place we haven't been. Alright, let's take a look over there again. It's a place we haven't been.
Mine. All right.
I'm talking about three tunnels. So if this counts as a tunnel... oh god.
This group shows promise exceptional.
Now we're going this way. There's something here.
Gotcha.
There's that.
Hey, how are things going? Something up?
Yeah, I want to go this way. Ah, there we go. Could be I missed something here. Crypt crawlers and greater ghouls. They move quick, so let me just get her out of the way.
Alright, alright.
Why me?
Let them cross the stupid stuff. Okay, crypt crawler down. Last one. And no one's held.
Why me?
He's nauseated, but that's okay. He's used to it. Just take a look here. Alright, good. She's done here. Still one here. There we go. Just trying to use up some of these stacks of stuff here. Okay. Pardon my micromanaging. I must have looked in here.
You can count on me. Good job.
We're all gonna run through here.
All right.
Huh. Not sure if there is anything else to activate in this area.
Why me?
Okay. It's a wand of paralyzation, I think.
This group shows promise exceptional.
So this is trapped over here.
All right.
Okay, an antidote and a potion of freedom. Fit right. No. Well, we know it's a wand of lightning. So I have not found what we're looking for here. It's just another room.
Why me?
I don't know. Found one here, one here. One was on a throne. And one was on a golem.
You save the day.
I didn't find anything. Oh! God damn, it's so loud. Can you become less nauseated quietly? Oh god. Someone give me a hint, right? I did it by mistake. No. I wanted to click over here. I mean, that's something to... These aren't anything I can activate. Maybe we don't need to click anything else. Maybe we just... Maybe we just, like, go through again. These dead ends are very suspicious, though. And it just ends here. It's weird. So I can tell there's something here. The throne. And squeeze through there. Okay, well, when you think about it, there's this area. This is only access, as far as I know anyway, by this area. So you get here last. Right? And then here, you get here last. And then through here... Yeah, I don't know. Let's return to that initial room again. Maybe I didn't miss something. Understand the paths that lead away, and you will return. Durlag knows the penalty for speaking once more to the Guardian. You are not he.
Incactus.
Cursed is but a flesh wound.
Ow.
All right.
Okay. Grouchy. Speaking once more to the Guardian. Highly frowned upon.
Why me?
Oh, wait, no. Not what I meant to do. Oh, there's a trap right there?
All right.
Hey, how are things going? Good job.
Oh, crap. Annoying.
Simple matter.
All right. Wow, she rolled a 15. Yeah, that's better. Wait, isn't she free?
All right, all right.
I couldn't select her with the circle. Does this thing punish us too? Well, that just turns the runes off. You'd think it would be in this room, actually. Being so heavily guarded. Oh, wait! Huh! That's it. Can we rest in here? Okay, good. Alright, let's
go
talk.
Go pester someone else.
Talk to these. Here, go pester these things.
Sure.
We followed Durlag. We were his people, his family. Durlag Trollkiller, son of Bolher Thunderaxe the Clanless, formed this place with the spoils of a lifetime of adventure. It was majestic in those times, and we took what we needed from the fortune around us. We grew strong and proud, and Durlag felt he finally had a home. We were the future, his family, and if we were lost, then so was he. That was the fear that hid, that was beneath. We followed Durlag. We were his people. Alright, took what we needed, but fortune around us, strong and proud. Okay, and this one of the, what do you call it, doppelgangers. We were the fear made flesh. We came to the home that Durlag built, and we hid in the temple that he formed. With tentacles to guide, we poisoned the clan, and the nightmares of Durlag came true. Our masters said they could taste his rage even in the air, but always there was the fear behind. We were the fear made flesh, but it was already here. We hid in the people that he formed. Tentacles to guide. There's the tentacles again. Taste of rage in the air. Wait, there was a fear behind. And then this one. We entrenched this place against all that would come. We built retribution in the tripwires and vengeance in the fireballs. We worked the hatred into every nook and cranny, just as he wished. But our actions were guided from elsewhere. The foundation was the fear that it could happen again, and this was to be prevented at all costs. This was the mortar that held him together. We entrenched this place against all that would come, friend and foe alike. And what do you want us to figure out? My father roamed as I, and saw much of the world in his time. Well respected he was, but he had no home. At the end he died in some faraway land with no dwarven kin by his side. I would not allow such to happen to me. I would not follow his steps that far. I would not be Durlag the Clanless. This was my fear. Trace the path of this fear and show me what you have learned. Began with you and your need for a home, with your clan as you feared losing them. It manifested in the invaders that came, but you feared they're coming already. Began with your clan, your fear of losing the craftsmen, fortify this place with it. Two seems likely. It began with the invaders and their threats against you. It grew in your people, and the thought that more might perish. It festered within you for a while before the craftsmen entrenched this place. I don't think it's three. It was the craftsmen and the worry that their work would protect you. It was in your people and that you feared you could not protect them. It was then in the invaders that feared your retribution. I don't think it's that one either. It began with your people with their fear of losing their home. The craftsmen built it as best as they could, but they were unsure of the quality they delivered. You were afraid of the invaders, but in the end they feared you. No, I don't think it's that one either. It began with you, but it rested mainly in your fear of the invaders. It followed to your people and then to the very walls of this place, which were entrenched by the craftsmen.
Squeaky wheel gets the kick.
Everyone stand back.
I need an ale. All right.
So, Trace. So his fear was to have no kin by his side. Trace the path of this fear. That was the fear that hid, that was beneath. If we were lost, and so was he. There the fear made flesh. Our masters said they could taste his rage, but always there was fear behind. With the fear that made flesh, but it was already here. I think it started with his family, and then the craftsmen, and then finally the invaders. I think it's two. It began with your clan and your fear of losing them. The craftsmen fortified this place with it, and then it manifested in the invaders. Now it haunts you always. You have not listened. Okay. Completely unharmed. Probably because... Wait. He has protection from electricity.
Why me?
That works out. Okay, maybe grew with the need for a home. It did not begin with the invaders. in the end they feared you. Not sure. It began with you and your need for a home. It grew with your clan as you feared losing them. It manifested in the invaders that came, but you feared their coming already. It became your home where it keeps you safe. You know a little more of me. You may yet live. Are we gonna get teleported? Okay. Okay, now what, spirit?
Ball plate and packing steel.
You will survive this place. You understand what built the hate. The fear. Protection for electricity helps too. Now you must prevent it becoming worse. A creature below, powerful beyond all. You must remove, or it shall make the place its own. Such a fortress, impenetrable if remade in his image. If there is evil to be fought, I will defeat it. There is always evil to be fought, within and without. Do as you will. The way is clear. Follow me. Alright, let's follow him.
Sure.
I swear I pressed that. Does he... Islan is down there. Are you going to Islan? I love the effect. Look at that. The running animation. All blurry. It's awesome. Oh, he undid the way here. She doesn't say anything new. Okay.
I don't... Sure.
Just in case it's trapped.
Good job.
All right. Ooh. Stop where you are. I have a bow trained on your neck, and you will not live to reach me. Claire Delane.